Hey everybody, Jang here from JANGBRiCKS.com with a look at a Mega Bloks Halo set. This is the Spartan Assault Battle Pack for the mid-year of 2014. Comes with 57 pieces officially. Of course, they call it Spartan Assault Battle Pack not because it's about Spartans assaulting anything, but because it's actually based on or derived from the Halo Spartan Assault game, the little mini game that they did, and that is why this includes, well, you see, you get this actual stand that is included with the set, but let's look at each individual figure up more closely. First and foremost, Commander Palmer. Finally, we get an official Commander Palmer figure from Mega Bloks, and yes, it is named, so you can actually call her Palmer this time. Also has the proper blue visor, and this is the proper Halo 4, 343 era design for all of the armor. Got the correct shoulder pads on there, and the most impressive thing to me is the application of the small details, the emblems, the lines and things. Also note that the plastic is not all one color. It's not all one color of silver, so it's actually got a little bit of speckling included in there, a little bit of gray, just kind of dirtying it up maybe, or just giving it texture. It doesn't look quite so dirty actually to me. It's just textured and different rather than being completely where, just a plain silver would be all smoother looking and just not as believable. This is pretty properly done. The only thing that's not great about these is that the shoulder armor is down kind of low and wide, and that's just because they need to have room around the joints. The weapon here is obviously a sniper rifle, and that's just molded in all black, and it does include the little bipod. This is the player character, Spartan Davis, with the recruit helmet there. And while Palmer, to me, was done about as right as it could possibly be done, this one's really lacking to me. For a named character to be in this lighter color and have no wash and have no distinction around the visor, especially since it's basically orange on gold, I would have wanted to see that visor be red. Not the same red as the first recruit helmet that they did, but definitely something darker than this, and that would stand out more, and with a black outline around it, because right now it just blends in, the visor and the main color, and these lighter colors with these thin pieces just let way too much light through. To me, they just look far too toyish. I fully realize that it's a toy. It's supposed to be a toy. That's good that it's a toy, but still, could have been much better. At the very least, it just needs a black outline around the visor so that doesn't just blend in. Kind of looks like a prototype to me. Here's an active camo Brute Miner using the new molds. There, now you can see it much, much better. This is nicely done. I like that. These molds work out well, I think, for the full clear. You can still see the texture when you look closely, especially around the upper leg there. Down around all around the back, the strappings around the ankles and the wrists, and you get an all clear brute shot here too. This is all good. I'm very happy with this one. Last up is a Brute Major. This figure is pretty perfect to me. The color is beautiful. The blue has might have multiple applications of it to kind of build it up, has a little bit of a candy kind of nature to it where you can see more extra depth than is actually there because it has just enough thickness and also a little bit of transparency to the material itself. A little bit of metallic flake in there, just really fine flake. Really nice detailing on the front. Got the blue in there on top of the gunmetal gray. Similar thing done on the shoulders, the shoulder armor pads. You got the little strappings again around the ankles and the wrists there. Got the blue on the back even down in this small little area here that really wasn't necessary. They could have gotten away with just leaving that all gunmetal gray since it's on the back, but this is proper. This is nicely done. Got the spiker there, got the spike grenade. Good figure. So that's it on this one for me. It's a shame about the Davis figure. Definitely needs some touch-up work, but the rest are great, and it's definitely still a must-buy for me personally. but of course not everybody will agree. Whether you agree or not, please do share your thoughts about this set, whatever your opinions are. If you have anything specific you would like to mention about the individual figures, or just want to leave a general comment about the whole thing, it's much appreciated. Please hit thumbs down or thumbs up on the video, whichever you prefer. Stick around for more videos to come.